Today, we have removed the death penalty. It has been hanging in the law books and it's been used by several governments to take away the opposition, to threaten them, to silence them. For me, I have decided that that is a thing of the past. And I took that to the Parliament of Sierra Leone, and it's off the law books today. Death penalty is no longer part of our laws. The seditious libel law. This is a law that has been used to threaten journalists, and a lot of them have been locked up. As I speak to you, that is also a thing of the past. And if you check in our prisons today, there is no journalist in prison for practicing journalism.
What about gender equity and empowerment, Mr. President? What is your administration doing about gender equity and empowerment?
When I took over, women were definitely at the edge. They did not have the necessary space. They did not have the necessary support. And what happened, apart from bringing a lot of women into governance, is to make sure that they feel a part of our development process. They feel a part of being Sierra Leone. And that is what we are doing. Rape was rampant. I declared a national emergency, and we have brought in new, we have amended the Sexual Offences Act, and now it is the punitive measures are stricter. We are having, we've set up courts, special courts for that. We have special centers, one-stop centers to deal with rape and other issues. My wife compliments me very well in that regard. She is out there all the time trying to get the schoolgirls in particular to understand that they are part of Sierra Leone, and that their hands are not given in marriage before they finish school, addressing issues like teenage pregnancy, addressing issues like sanitary pads, which is keeping kids away from school for nearly 70 days in the school year.
Let's talk about inclusive development as a strategy.
Correct.
Let's look at how do you think Sierra Leoneans feel part of this inclusive development? Because some people have said that it appears that certain parts of the country that voted for you are being developed to the contrary to others that did not necessarily support you. So would you say that all Sierra Leoneans feel part of this inclusive development that you have been talking about?
The biggest development we have today is free quality education for every child in Sierra Leone, not for any region. Be you from the north, the south, the east, and the west, the resources we have provided is for every child. That is inclusive. For me, that is in fact the most important thing. So the same opportunity my daughter has to go to school is the same opportunity you have in every part of the country, even if you cannot afford it. The government comes to, let's say, the infrastructure development that most people talk about. At the time I took over, I come from the south, and the south and the southeast are normally blended together. In most part of the north, every district headquarter can be reached on a paved road. And in most part of the south and the east, most district headquarters cannot be reached on a paved road. So what do we do? If we are talking about inclusion, you make sure that every district headquarter can be reached on a paved road. The district where I come from has no paved road, not even a meter of paved road. I have to fix that.